getting started. Whoo, that audio spiked. I cranked up the gain on the mic. So we'll see how everything goes. Let me just check to see if I'm connected. We are, but this thing is screwed up. There we go. Sorry, I'm still kind of figuring out what we're doing. Oh, hey Barry, what's up? I am, like, using the mouse left-handed, which is super awesome. How's the audio, Barry? Is it good? Or is the music too loud? We're trying to hack the VOD, but we don't want to hack the audio. Yeah, it's fine. Cool. Turn this up a little. Okay. All right. Cool. I think we're about ready to start. Okay. I did a bunch of these like little guys. This is like 5x7. We're gonna work on that Wolverine one in like a minute. I did a bunch of them for Heroes Con. Well, I did like four of them. Like, loose pencils. But I kind of want to like warm up my hand a little, so we're gonna work a little bit on these, like, Batman throwing batarangs. Here's the thing about Batman throwing batarangs. I reffed all of these from, well, except for this one and this one, which were like a disaster. I did those first, and then I was like, oh god, I need reference for this. This is a complicated pose. So, I, reffed, like, pitchers. So we're gonna, I'm just gonna, like, kind of warm up a little bit. How's everybody doing today? We're like fast and loose, kind of like, I'm trying to also, by the way, the reason that I'm doing like a little bit of warm up is because I want to make sure the camera's good. Man, I really, like, want to improve the camera quality. If we're gonna start, like, so this camera is just, like, a webcam, and, it puts out HD, but like, the HD is like not great. Forgot a finger. Sorry. It's a better camera than, yeah, it's a step up from the built-in laptop camera. Like, It's better than that, but not by much. I started looking into like trying to get like what it would take to get a I talked about this on the last stream, like better video. Spoiler alert, it's expensive. That's the only reason I haven't done it yet. We'll still do it. We'll still do it eventually. But yeah, man. Sorry, I wanted to change that. That was Red Fang, but I don't know. I'm not feeling it right now. This is just like the normal playlist I listen to while I work. Alright, I feel like we're getting warm. Wait a minute, all good, just a week ago. Crew at my house, and we party every weekend. So on the radio, that's my favorite song. Make me bounce around like I don't know, like I won't be here long. Now the thriller's gone, got no patience, cause I'm not a doctor. Go, why is you lying? Girl, why you Mufasa? Yeah, me casa su casa. Gotta strip it like Gaza. I kinda like this Batman, by the way. The flow is so lava. Yeah, we spit that saliva. iPhone got message from Viber. Either the head is so hydra, or we let bygones be bygones. My God, keep throwing those rings. Alright, we're warm, more warm. Let's get to the real shit. It's weird. The camera should lock focus too. This is the other thing. I'm just scared of the future. I got your back, we can do this. Hold up. No matter what you say, what you do. This is the other aspect of this camera. I'm gonna try to adjust, make this a little bigger. Hopefully I'm not gonna hit my head against this thing. That might be a tall order. You thought maybe for some. Man. That drives me crazy. This is okay. Let's talk real quick. You would totally hit your. Yeah, I've done it twice while setting up. Hit my head against it. I used to care what people thought, but now I care more. I'm gonna put a scrap paper here. Therefore, I've lost all hope of a happy ending, depending on whether or not it's worth it. So insecure, no one's perfect. Oh no, you guys, I just realized. I wrote one of my ideas on here, VCR Ghost. You guys can steal that idea now. I don't know if that's a fully fleshed out idea. They don't care. Kind of sad, but I'm laughing. Whatever. All right, let's figure out what we're doing with this Wolverine. Cabin, Labrador, yapping. I'm glad that it happened. I mean it. Between us, I think there's something special. And if I lose my mental, just hold the cousin of KG Beast. Yeah. No matter what you say, what you do. Well, the idea was that, like, if you died in the 80s and you're like, I have unfinished business, and like, whoever, the arbiter of the afterlife, was like, man, I really gotta get looser. Whew, I'm tense. I need a shot. The arbiter of the afterlife's like, hey. You need to pick like an object to haunt, because you know there's like haunted objects. And if you're a 1980s guy, you're like, oh well, I'm gonna haunt my family, because that's what you do, as far as I know. You haunt your family. And you're like, what can my family not do without? You're like, the kids are always watching something on the dang VCR. I'm gonna haunt the VCR. Um, So then you haunt the VCR, and then, like, eventually DVD players come out, and you're like, oh no. But your family's thrifty, and they're not getting one, so you're like, oh, thank God. But then eventually, like, they do get one, because they get a PS2 or something. And then you're like, oh shit, what am I going to do? My family's got, like, a... My family's getting rid of this VHS. They're getting rid of all their tapes. You see the writing on the wall. And then you're like, shit, my unfinished business. I don't know if you guys caught that on camera. I just almost dropped the brush. That's how loose I am now. And the VCR ends up in a landfill. And it ends up in a landfill with a bunch of other VCRs. With a bunch of other VCR ghosts. Just a bunch of 80s guys hanging out in the landfill. That was my idea for VCR ghost. I don't know if there's like... There might be something to that, to the VCR ghost. I think VCR ghost has legs. Is this the sequel to Paper Girls? It's the sequel everybody thought they wanted. But as it turns out... I'm trying to kind of stay loose with this. We're gonna always, as always... This chair is uncomfortable. I'm uncomfortable. As always, with all of this... Everything that we ink down isn't necessarily going to stay there, because we're always, always going to be able to throw down some white out. I like this Wolverine the best out of the four that I made. I made a Rook, a Ben, both of them from the Realm, and a Wolverine, and then Thor. But we'll see what happens with those. I penciled those a lot looser than this Wolverine. So, I don't know, we'll see. I'm like, this thing is right in front of my face. This camera is useless. This is why I have to get a nicer camera. So that I can, like, actually move it up a little bit more than where it is now. Anyway, I felt good about this Wolverine. He's got a lot going on. Man, I I finally got ahead of everything that I needed to work on. If you guys want like a sneak peek on like a comic colorist goes to a con, this is what I've done since you saw me last. What I've done since you saw me last was ten pages of Star Wars, which I still need to correct. I just got the corrections in today. And then almost a full issue of Nightwing is in the can. I almost wanted to like black out the whole bottom of Wolverine's face. It looks like he's got like black lips. These were gray. Maybe. I kind of like, I'm not like the like finest crosshatcher, but I do kind of like it every once in a while. Gotta love that Star Wars gray. Yeah. They really liked it. They didn't have any notes as far as like the gray goes. It was all like actually, I don't know. I only glanced at the notes. It didn't look like any stuff that was gray needed to come out. We're gonna just go right over the claws right here. So, man, this is not on the same level at all. We're gonna wipe that out. Maybe incorporate it into the background. It's about rolling with those punches. I'm also like smudging the shit out this paper, man. Cool. This is like an old pad that I cut these smaller squares out of, and holy god, this paper was not cooperating. All right. There's like something about this paper that just like lends itself to just smudge city. All right, maybe we should have penciled the hands a little bit better. Now that past Nick Flaherty fucked us. I'm kind of annoyed by that. Let's take the ink out of this and like figure out these hands just a little bit more. Past Nick Flaherty fucked us. They like, the hands just kind of like look weird to me, so we're gonna just tweak it. This is why you made a comic of robots, the hands are evil? Yeah. What if Wolverine is actually a robot and he's got little claw hands? Luckily, we're doing, like, closed palms, so, like, or, like, fists. He's basically a robot frame inside of flesh. That's true. So, like, hopefully they won't be too much of a pain in the ass. The other thing that I'm worried about is, like, the arms on the side, but we're working on, like, such a small thing that maybe we can just kind of, like, fudge it. Wolverine's got these, like, things down his chest, but I don't think he has anything here. I think that's just blank, so... And then this is like a hairy arm kind of thing, right? And I think we can probably like crosshatch our way out of that, maybe? Famous last words? Yeah, famous last words. We're gonna crosshatch our way out of that. You see how freaking loose my pencils are. I'm like, this block is a finger, this block is a finger. These circles are knuckles. We're all done. Let's wrap it up. The reason all my pencils are loose is because if they're not, I'll get bored really, really quickly. Shannon says that my biggest... I wonder if we can actually kind of start to erase a little bit of Wolverine in here. See what we're actually working with. Shannon says, I am my own worst enemy. Because of my ADHD. That, like, if I could just focus up and, like, draw a hand six times in a drawing, then, like, maybe the drawing would be better. And maybe she's right. She's probably right. She's usually right. But we don't live in that world. I mean, we live in the world where Shannon is probably right, but we don't live in the world where figure out my ADD problem. Look at this, we didn't even finish this hand. Let's finish this. This is a classic Wolverine pose, by the way. One of the things that I really like about Daniel Warren Johnson art is that he does not do stuff like this. He always kind of like puts a spin on it. I did not do that. Buy a commission from Daniel Warren Johnson if you want that. Look, I'm not the boss of you. So after I told you to not shop with me, look, I haven't done a lot of commissions yet, so I'm not bored of, like, the typical poses yet. These knuckles are huge. Let's shrink the hand just a little bit. Knuckle, knuckle, knuckle. This all makes sense, right? Okay. So, if you guys remember, I was drawing on stream a while ago, but I was doing, like, these, like, just take characters from Realm Umbrella Academy, you shouldn't get bored. Yeah, you're probably right. You know, Space Boy is particularly challenging to draw. He's got, like, weird proportions. But the other thing is like, I don't know if I want to put myself, like, alongside Ba. Like, Ba's so damn good that it's, like, I don't want to, like, purposely kind of go there. You know? But yeah, there's no, like, typical, like, realm or, I get what you're saying. There's no typical realm or umbrella commission. Alright. These weird little, like, things on the gloves where the claws pop out. We're gonna hit these with white out so they don't have to be perfect. Because we're gonna make them, like, kind of like bling. The claws are, or the gloves are dark, so we're gonna try to just, like, roll with that. Try to put, like, a little bit of highlight in them to make them look like, I don't know. Like a latex or whatever. It's picking up, like, a little bit of the light around. It looks a little sloppy, but we'll make it work. We should put the claws in. I kind of want to use a ruler for that. So let's finish the gloves. For the amount that I draw X-Men, I'd spend my time thinking about drawing X-Men. And the amount of time I was about to grab an X-Men toy. For the amount of time that I spend with the X-Men, I do not read a ton of X-Men books. Which is weird, but whatever. I'll never even close my eyes. This is my childhood right here. I recently put, like, a bunch of stuff from my childhood into the playlist. There are too many, yeah, X-books. Yeah, there's a lot of X-books. I cannot keep track. Every once in a while, I'll, like, dip in and be like, I don't know what's going on, and I'll dip right back out. Alright, we're gonna cover that with mostly claws, so. There are too many X-books and they overlap more than the Gotham books, yeah. Okay, I know I said I was gonna use a ruler. But fuck rulers. Never use them. We're just gonna focus, is what we're gonna do. It's never over. We're just gonna focus and also trust that we're gonna white it out later. I appreciate that you may not want to listen to this music that we're playing right now, but this isn't your channel. So we're doing what I want to do. I like how this is coming out, which is weird. I hope that it does not go awry. Now I feel nice and loose. If you can't tell. Because I'm like, whatever. Thumb! The music volume's really low. Good. Okay. Good. I hate when a streamer just kind of like... It's like, this is what I'm listening to, and you have no other option. And you're just like, oh, I guess we're locked into this. I like it when it's like low enough for you to be like, maybe we'll turn the stream down a little bit and listen to whatever you want kind of thing. Give you an option. We're gonna try to put like a little bit of stitching in there with a little bit of white out. So I don't know if you guys remember, but we were doing sketches that were a lot bigger than this one. Man, is that camera like autofocusing like all the time? I hope it isn't. I'm just gonna try to watch it for a second. Now I'm paranoid that it's auto-focusing all the time. So yeah, what was I saying? Oh. Jeremy Hahn was like, gave me some really good advice when it came to doing commissions. He was like, think about how much time you want to spend on it. And if you want to spend a lot of time on one big piece and sell that big piece for like an exorbitant amount of money, do that. If you wanna, but if you work smaller, you can do a lot of little ones. So I was like, this one right here is 5x7. I'm gonna see if I can. The paper is curling. We're throwing down so much ink. I love it. Let me see if we can. Alright, I think I turned off the autofocus. We're gonna find out right now. Yes, I did turn off the autofocus. Perfect. So he was like, yeah, like, how much is your time worth? How much are you gonna get for a piece? Like, I'm a, like, known colorist, but unknown entity when it comes to, like, the art world. So, like, do I want to put in, like, you know, multiple days into one big giant piece and then not sell it, or do I want to make like a bunch of like little pieces, you know? And they love him because. So that's what I decided to do. Well, every hero needs. All right, let's figure out these claws are a little harder than the other ones. Where's the start? I need a pencil. We need to figure this out. I had a ruler. Where the hell did it go? Oh, there it is. I gotta wait till this dries a little bit. Yeah, so it's kind of like, I don't know, where do you want to spend your time? I'm a little off camera right now, but trust me, this isn't anything worth looking at. There we go. This piece, by the way, is a really big deal for me because this is the first time I've gotten Wolverine's mask to look kinda alright. Obviously, it's not perfect, but man, this is the closest I've ever gotten to like a competent Wolverine. So, you know, maybe I'm, oh my god, look at that bump in the straight line. Sorry, we're gonna put a ton of white out on this, so let's throw this thing in. This weird like little like shoulder pad thing. Those little like triangles. Alright, let's get nasty. With some spot blacks. Now I'm loose. Now I'm fucking loose as hell. Ooh, this thing's curling. This thing's going on a book later. Flatten it out. Dry brush in here. So you looking at me, girl. When I first set foot into the room, you didn't want me to see, girl. You didn't want to lay your cards so soon. So one of the things that I learned from like years of comic coloring that I didn't understand when I was like in school. When I was trying to make things out of school, like directly out of school, I was like, okay, everything has to be perfect always. You know, like, there's a right way to draw a pectoral muscle. There's a right way to draw, you know, whatever. And as I got older, I realized, man, I'm just going to lay my hand right across all the inking that I did. That's what I'm going to do. Just smudge the shit out of it. As I got older, I realized, oh, actually nothing matters. The world is a cold, dry place, and nobody cares about anything. What I realized was that, like, as long as it's, like, engaging, it doesn't matter. It can be perfectly drawn and boring as hell, and I would rather have something imperfectly drawn. I would rather have something imperfectly drawn and, like, interesting, which is, like, what I try to go for. And I actually, I recently got a correction on something that was like, hey, can we start making this instead, like, I do a lot of mark making in my coloring. We're gonna cap this for right now. I think we're done with ink. We're gonna start putting some white out down. But yeah, I got a correction. Look at that. Perfect. Perfect. I'm gonna wash my hands for a second. Yeah, so I got this correction that was like, hey, can we, like, smooth out the rendering? Like, basically make it superhero airbrushed. And, like, man, I live in this space that is not superhero airbrushed. Like, this is the space that I live in. Like, crazy mark making, like, hand of the artist, like, total... I don't know. That's what I like. All right, so let's start throwing on some white ass. Yeah, they know what's up. Polo socks, polo tee, polo bib, polo sheets, photo biz, photo jeep, photo booth, hoes of me. She take a photos of me that she carry all around like rosaries. She said she never did it with the lights on. Baby, we gon' see. She's so cow, she know how. She no smoke, she no talk. She no chance, she no Vic. She no gang, she gon' go. Wear your heels, wear your clothes. Wear your hair in the bun when you head back home. Wear your purse, wear your phone. One more question before y'all go. Where all the girls at? With the credit cards and the high heels. The Mercedes Benz with the big wheels. When they hit his jam. Frank Miller, guest today. Yeah, right? I do like putting down some black. Hey, you know what the secret is, by the way? If you put down a ton of black, then you don't have to draw the thing. If everything's in shadow, you don't have to draw anything. Oh, we gotta get rid of this one line. We probably should have erased some of this stuff before. Also, something that I didn't realize when I was going to school was that, like, there's value to conveying the emotion rather than doing things the right way. I mean, and that's cartooning. That's just like... get that clavicle expression is everything. Yeah, I hear ya. Man, this is like the first second I've had to myself to work on this stuff. I wanted to be doing this stuff on stream all week long, but like, I wasn't able to. I'm actually blowing off Star Wars corrects right now. I'll do them today. It'll be fine. This reminds you of Howard Chaykin? A little bit, I guess. I haven't read a lot of, or maybe any Howard Chaykin? And this is a classic Captain America. After Howard Chaykin, that kind of, like, terrible... super problematic book recently, I was like, maybe I'm not gonna look into Howard Chaykin. This is a problem that I have. It's really hard for me to separate art from artist. And like, when somebody is crappy, like when I don't agree with somebody's like political views or whatever, it's really difficult for me to like get into the book. Alright, let's make the claws pop. Let's blow this off a little bit. This is a classic Captain America. When in doubt, black it out. Amen! I just bumped the camera with my head, I apologize. I'm gonna be selling this at Heroes. Little 5x10 guys. Or, sorry, 5x7. Man, I kinda wanna like... Shoulders look a little weird, but that's alright. Just leave it to the imagination a little bit. I guess we'll work on the next one. Sign this guy, I guess. But the rough style is a similar feel. Yeah, I really like this rough kind of stuff. Like, this is definitely the headspace that I live in. And it's like... I guess I should date it too, since it's a drawing. Come on, Whiteout, don't fail me now. There we go. Alright, one in the can. We're all loose and warmed up now. Let's take a worse drawing and do that again. Where'd the other drawings go? Nothing is prepared on this stream. This isn't Humble Beginnings, is it? No, this is Midtown. You're cursed with being more tight. I like being sketchy and rough. Where the hell is that damn drawing? Let's work. This is like super rough. Let's work on this rook. So I just like being rough. Like, rough stuff, like, clicks with me. Gabe is a good dude. I will take your word for it. Oh, Humble Beginnings was Gabe's from Midtown's previous band. Man, you guys are deep in it. Like, here I thought I was a fan. So this is Rook from The Realm, which is a book that I work on. I do color work for it. Jeremy Hahn does the art. This is his design. So I kind of wanted to do like a background, but not anything like crazy. Just like maybe just like this, and we just black it out up here. And then like I wanted to leave like this dome shape, like just totally white. Maybe all the way white all the way around. I'm trying to think of the light. So this is the thing. It's like lean into your strengths. Well, they're from New Jersey, so you are moderately friendly with them. I hear you. For anyone that doesn't know, Fake McCoy was in a ska band, which makes him cooler than most people. Sorry to just out you like that, Fake McCoy. Yeah, you want to lean into your strengths, and mine is like figuring out where the light source is, you know? So, let's figure that out. I think I want to do like a total silhouette all the way around, pull like some Chris Somney bullshit, where we kind of like figure this out. Kind of did the same thing we did on Wolverine's forehead. Nothing wrong with some ska. Used to live in this scene. Nice! Yeah, 2000, like, 97 to, like, 2002-ish was my kind of heyday. Where did the brush go? Everything's a mess on this string. Everything's a mess. I'm also kind of curious, like, how much of this Twitch is going to mute in the VOD. Man, you just cannot open a thing of ink without getting it on me. Every damn time. Yeah, Refused is great. Man, there was this, ridiculous song that is actually in the playlist that I hope doesn't come up because it's very lewd, by speaking of Refused, this just reminded me of this. I put this song in, where is it, Holy Child, this song Bathroom Bitch. I'm gonna remove it from the playlist because it is really lewd. Are you the guy listening to grunge in early aughts in high school? I can feel you on that. Like, I was also a grunge kid, but that band Holy Child, they did an album that they called The Shape of Brat Pop to Come, And I was like, nice. Miles Davis refused reference. I dig that. Okay, so... Rook's helmet is really cool. Jeremy did a great job with the design of this. It's got a lot of like knobs and dealies and stuff, so it's got a lot of like raised edges, and we're just gonna try to stay loose and try to have fun with it. I keep reaching for my mouse on my left side, it's on my right. Okay. But I was like, when I was at Dallas Comic Con, I was at a benefit for someone's transition, and it was like a live art thing. It was super fun. Ooh, this line is... That was something... Oh my god, we're all over the place. Somebody should have stopped me. Chat, I blame you. It was a really good event, and, oh man, I made that just totally straight, huh? Okay, alright. Let's just... Everything's out the window on this one. Our entire structure is gone. This is why we ink at home and not at the show. At this live art thing, that song came on, and it was like cracking Robert up. Robert Wilson IV. He was doing the Spider-Gwen. This is what happens when you brag about your Wolverine mask. Yeah, I fuck up the mask I know very, very well. Whatever, we'll get there. We'll get there. I hope I'm not... I feel like I'm leaning into the camera, and I kind of am, but I'm not leaning in front of it, thank God. I think I might have goofed the proportions a little bit. Like, I think the mask is actually a little bit squatter. Let me think about this for a second. Or maybe not. It's hard for me to tell right now. You can fix anything with some black and white out. Yeah, I know. Tell me about it. Like, if anything, we'll just leave it to the colorist to figure out. That's a thing, right? People do that all the time. I think if we can make it look good, then it doesn't matter what the mask looks like. We can kind of like play in the space. I'm avoiding the edges because we're going to be like blacking those out. Also, Robert saw some of my drawings when we were at Dallas, and he accused me of a heavy right-handed bias, so we didn't draw this on the computer, so we probably have a heavy right-handed bias, and I don't even realize. I was like, He told me that, and I was like, dude, I don't even know how to fix that. Like, or I was thinking that. I was like, right-handed bias. Like, what do I even do for that? I thought I turned my mobile off, but apparently I just got a text message from my apartment complex that you guys couldn't see. I thought you could see it. Always. Always saves the day. It was funny, You're not my monster comment like that. Yeah, I have like this album in particular, I have like vivid memories of being in high school and or maybe early college, maybe probably high school. And listening to this album, I don't know if it was high school or early college, but I remember listening, vivid memory, sitting in the parking lot of the grocery store while I was on break from working at the grocery store, and listening to this album for like the first time, basically. Like, I like bought it and then went to work. And being like, I fucking love this, and not wanting to go back to work, but I did go back. I did go back to work. Because I'm a good proletariat, or bourgeoisie. I don't know. Whatever. I'm good at making other people money. At a moderate rate. Oh god, that's too true. Stay loose. Stay loose. Don't get murdered. Ted Leo, this is your weird shit. There we go. Hold on. I'm figuring out what I want to listen to. Main reason why I'm loose with all kinds of drawing and stuff like this is because I cannot focus enough to not be loose. Like, if I go super technical, by the time I'm like done with the drawing, I'd lose the forest or the trees like almost immediately, and I like will scrutinize a finger that does not fucking matter. And the other reason that is because I can't stay focused. I just fucking can't. Like, I will draw a portion of it very, very well, and then be like, well, I hate this, I'm bored, and I don't know why I'm doing this. So, you remember doing a Third Engine cover in your band around that time? We played a show with Thursday, where they put out Waiting. When one of the guys from Thursday went to Savannah College of Art and Design in like the year before I was there, so 99, he was buddies with one of my roommates at the time, and yeah, I don't know. That story doesn't go anywhere, I guess. You're welcome. I have a loose Third Thursday connection, is what I'm trying to say. Hey, my fiance was in Jason Black's wedding. From Hot Water Music, okay? That's my claim to fame. You don't know me. This isn't about me. Shoulders are like super low, like they should be here. Oh man, I smudged the shit out of that. That's all right, we meant to do that. Like, I don't know, maybe the shoulders should be here. We're gonna do some like Somni thing, and I feel like I just kind of lost track of it. Maybe we still will, maybe. All right, time to put the brush away and take out the Great Equalizer and just try to experiment with how horrible we're gonna make this part. Like, I kind of want to just do like this. I think that should be fine. It probably will go. Probably go together. Let's find out. I'm gonna practice up here a little bit. A little Sharpie action. Always. Dude, I saw Jock do like a little video online of like how he works, and I was like, are you fucking kidding me? I was like, are you kidding me? I was like, I gotta get a Sharpie immediately. Put one in my hands. I've been trying to like figure out exactly how to use them. I know they're not like archival quality or whatever, but like, he's out of a box of black Sharpies. Hell yeah. Like, I mean, okay, so this is the Sharpie I'm using now, but I do have this guy as well, but this guy actually has the same size chisel tip. Slightly different. So I don't use the king size. What I wanted to get, apparently, was the Magnum, and I went with king size. What's bigger, king size or Magnum? Like, who knows? Brains, Alright. Maybe we should wash our brush, maybe? I don't know. Whatever. We'll destroy that brush. When I was at Dallas, by the way, not Dallas, Emerald City, Jeremy saw me doing a sketch. I was doing a Rook cover sketch on like a blank sketch cover, and he was like, I sold it, you know, and he was like, how much you sell that for? And I was like, I don't know, $20. And he was like, you have to charge more. So I don't know what I'm going to charge at Heroes. I think maybe 40 and see how that goes. The problem with Heroes is like the competition is like fucking crazy. So I don't know. We'll see. The Realm has, like, for anybody who hasn't read, has all this kind of, like, ash. Just hit that mic. So, like, I'm trying to, like, put a little bit of that in. But yeah, I thought it was funny that he was like, I was like, I don't know, $20, and he was like, "What are you doing? You're destroying the economy." So I think these are gonna go for 40. We'll see. The other thing is, though, like, if I come back with a lot of these things, it's not, like, the end of the world. You know, like, just bring them to the next show. I don't know. But I was thinking about, like, if I get nice and used to this, that, we might do these pretty regularly on stream, and then also we may, or you can sell them online. Yeah, exactly. It's like, I don't know, they sell, they don't sell. I'll figure it out. It's no big deal. Alright, what are we doing here? I think this rook is done. Yeah, I don't know what I was saying. That if we end up doing these kind of often, that it would be nice to try to do Inktober as well. Like, and just bang out like 31 of them. that'll be particularly great because you know, it'll give us like a nice like stack, and I won't like have to do a million going to a show or feel like I have to do a million. I don't know. You're gonna start this year doing October, and then you and then releasing an annual Inktober art book. Yeah, that could be a good thing to do. I see a lot of people doing that. All right, Rook is done. What do you guys think? I think it came out pretty good. We'll see if the Sharpie influences one a person one way or another. I know some people like archival stuff. Like, here's what we got so far. I feel like we're cooking. We're cooking. Thank you, Sean. What time is it? 4 o'clock? Let's do a third. This is Thor. Hi, Thor. I keep bumping this thing with my head. Yeah, but you create a good balance since the Sharpie isn't super black. Thanks, Fake McCoy. I kind of like that. I was thinking about, like, should I put, you know, gray tone in here? I think that might be a future thing. As long as it's not 100% Sharpie, it should be fine. Yeah. Because even if this guy fades, if the background fades on that one, like, it's the background, you know? So. Alright, we gotta kind of do some small tweaks to this before we get started, so I'm gonna try to close up this guy, the ink here. Give me a second. Oh god, this is crumbling. So I have the honor of At Heroes being across the table from Paul as a Seda, and just like putting out these drawings and then just like feeling bad about myself, that'll be fun. So, I wanted to do this because I wanted to draw a bunch of lightning, but I didn't actually, like, think this out. So, maybe we'll think it out a little bit more. Remember one time at school, Bob showed us the page by either Gil Kane or Gene Colan, I forget which, but it was inked entirely with Sharpie and it was fucking amazing. Yeah. Dude, I watched... Like, whenever I see, like, as a Seda work or Jock work, it, like, clicks with me in a very, like, real way. Because it's so much of it is about, like, imperfection. When I see stuff that's, like... Even Jim Lee used to solely use Sharpie. Yeah. When I see stuff that's, like, super, super tight, like, I'm just kind of bored. I don't know. Maybe that's just me. So this one's going to be a bit of a hike. So it's going to be a bit of a hike. So I want to do this, like, hair stuff, but I feel like the hair stuff is going to be, like, mostly white out, and I don't even want to, like, think about it, but, like, I kind of have to think about it. And the lightning is going to be there, and it's going to be mostly white out. So I was like, I don't know, the hammer. And, like, that was it. That's all I drew. I was like, whatever. We're done now. Drew the hammer. She has, like, a bracer, right? We'll probably do the same thing as Wolverine and kind of, like, black this stuff out in the corner. But, Mignola using Sharpie for layouts? I can absolutely 100% see that. Yeah, here, let's open the trash book for a second. I recently was like, so I'm trying to, like, wrap my mind around Sharpie. And I did this, like, quick Batman in just, like, straight-up Sharpie. And there's something about this that just, like, makes sense to me. Just like, oh, solid blacks. Here we go. But I don't know. It took me a long time to figure that out. This is all Sharpie and white out. This Batman with... I tried to put, like, brass knuckles on him, but it didn't really work. Yeah, I don't know. More Batman. Anyway. Let's get back to drawing what we should be drawing. It is hot in Florida, by the way. I might have to look up Thor. Give me a second. I'm gonna be back in the chat in a second. You guys are on your best behavior. I forgot what her whole, like, chest piece looks like. Okay. Sure. You guys are on your best behavior, right? While I'm looking at Raph. Spent so many years with, It's Nice in Charlotte. Man, it is hot in Florida. It's nice that it's nice in Charlotte. Spent so many years with Sharpie and whiteout that you're used to it. You can evolve spotting blacks and... Yeah. Being smart with contrast. 64. Good lord. I might tilt this thing. Because I'm dying. Oh, that feels a lot better. I'm sure the hum is picking up on the mic. Alright. Dinged that mic! Or ding the camera. Oh, I really dinged it. You're in Chicago, and it's not too bad there? Yeah. Now's when the north starts getting really nice. Alright, so there's gonna be, like, hair. This is all hair. This is all hair. This is hair. We don't have to plan any of this. We should totally be planning this. The thing is, like, and I'm gonna put hair over here. I don't know how to plan it. Like, other than, like, just sharpieing it. If I was drawing it for real, like, if they were like, hey, Nick, draw Jane Foster Thor for us, and I was like, sure, no problem, Marvel. I'd probably just do all the hair digital. The con shouldn't be so bad. 79. Yeah, it's not too bad. Also, let's figure out what we're going to do for the lightning. Oh, we can use the lightning to cover up what we don't want to draw. That's perfect. Get that covered up drawing. Draw smarter, not harder. Alright, I think I know what we're doing now. Alright. Yeah, my home of Connecticut is pretty nice right now. We're gonna take a trip up there, see my dad. He's not in Connecticut, he's in like outside of Boston. Alright, wait. Before we visit my dad in Boston, let's figure out what we're doing. I kind of think these things should be shorter. And like a little slicker. Yeah. These looked like too cute. She's a badass, so we want to make her a badass. And this should probably pop out on the other side. I know this is like the third time I've done this on a helmet, but like, it really is justified here because this is where like the core shadow would be, because we'd have light source and light source, so everybody can get stuffed. So I have a style. Cut me some slack. I'm gonna do some like cool metal stuff in here, if that's what that is. Alright. Alright. This song. I don't know if we're gonna listen to this song. The song is about taking people to Booty City. Yeah, here we go. Alright. I feel like we've lost a little bit of light for some reason. Whatever, it'll be fine, right? When we start putting down black, it's because we're using gray. Yeah, it'll be fine. Okay. This is definitely going to be my last one. Should we do the lightning? We're just gonna draw three things. I was thinking about like, should we do the lightning first so we know where we're not drawing? But I feel like we're just gonna draw through some stuff and then wait it out. Back in New York by peeps and a dog in a two-bedroom doing menial jobs, plus rhyming and stealing and being a clock, distractions, freedom abroad. I left some years of giving a light, I left some will the spirit away, I left my fears materialize, I left my skills deteriorate. When about a thought of what I should have been, continuing a mission that was rooted in a 20-year affinity and rickety condition with an ID crisis. Snap on the front lawn, look up in the sky, it's The nose is a little weird, but we're gonna roll with it. Because I kind of don't know how to fix it. By the way, when I started thinking about doing this again, I was pretty nervous. Not only about, like, drawing on stream, because, like, it is not my skill. It is not what I professionally do. But I was also like, man, like, I'm nervous about doing this at the show. I'm nervous about, like, doing this on stream. And it was that same kind of nervousness that I have every time I do something that I'm, like, really excited about, like, something that I end up loving. So, just FYI, do the things that scare you. It's not that hard. Look at that. Look at that. Gutsy. Gutsy blacks. Feasible anxiety is brutally committed to relinquishing his privacy, aligning with the trials of the anti-Midas. Snap on the back lawn, look up in the sky, it's shapes falling out of the fringe. All heart though we would have made cowardly kings. They will chop you down just to count your rings. Just to count your rings. Just to count your rings. And now we're colors pouring out of the fringe. All heart though. Hey Nick, you should be careful with that helmet. Fuck you, you don't know me. Let's get nuts. Let's get buck wild. I'm getting sick and tired of never understanding. Where is the truth you promised? Alright. So, where would the lips be? These are the eyes. Nose. Don't look at me. Yeah, exactly. We're just gonna, man, I just wanna like jam the lips in there, but I know that their placement is important, which is annoying. We can't just, like, jam. I kind of want to make the hammer just like straight freaking black, because the lightning is going to be white. I don't know if that's the right impulse or not, but we're gonna find out. Maybe just like this kind of thing. Just like fucking loosey-goosey. That's a technical art term that I learned when I was in college. I spent $80,000 to learn loosey-goosey. You guys can have that for free, because I care about you. Yeah, the thing that I realized about, like, having this, like, fear that, like, Oh, I don't want to draw on stream. Oh, I don't know. Maybe I don't. This is the voice. This is the voice that was like getting me. Is I don't know if I have the time to do these sketches this year. Maybe we'll do it next year. As soon as the voice in my head said, maybe we'll do it next year, I was like, nah, dog. Like, I know what this is because I've heard it every single year for the last 5 years. I was like, we just got to power through, get some sketches done, put them out there. Because it's never going to just happen suddenly. You know, we gotta make it happen. And that's that fear. That's that fear being like, maybe you're not ready yet. Maybe you shouldn't do this. Maybe there's gonna be people there that are better than you. Like, that's totally 100% the fear. You gotta overpower that. Nobody makes shit being afraid. Nobody makes cool shit being afraid. And like, if you never get started, you never go anywhere. So it's like, well, let's throw some lightning down. Sorry, I'm focusing on the lightning, which is why I'm quiet. I'm also starting to get tired. I only have so much of this in me per day. Plus, like, man, I should really pack for this con. I haven't done any of that yet. Just spotting blacks in here because I don't want to draw the chess piece. Plus, if we spot a lot of blacks in here, it's gonna look really, really good with the lightning. Or sorry, with the hair, not the lightning. Yeah, I can tell that I'm getting tired because my hand's starting to shake. I need a break and food. I do want to finish this, though. These are like sloppy Kirby dots. This is a good candidate for a Matt Wilson marker commission. Yeah, man. I would love it if somebody gave Matt a drawing that I had made for him to marker up. That would be a great moment for me. Matt, for anybody who doesn't know, Matt and I are good friends, and went to the same school, graduated in the same class, known each other for a long time, virtually got our start in the same way. So I think it'd be kind of funny. What's up, Fish? Shit, we metal now. Alright, we're gonna finish this up, this black up here, and then we're gonna put in some white out. You'll do it with the rumor piece? Cool. Better do like a good rumor piece then. Nothing going on. Job searching? Nice. I hope you find something, man. Alright, I think we gotta do the hair. I just kind of realized that we have an opportunity because we blacked out this hammer to do something cool. This one is super loose, though. Way looser than the other two that we did. But I kind of like it. So we have an opportunity to do something really cool with the hammer. We can put the, like, whosoever able to lift powers of Thor, like, thing into the text into the hammer. I don't know exactly what it says, so we're gonna kind of, like, do some letters kind of thing that are, like, too small for the reader to read because I'm illiterate and can't put actual writing down, and then we'll write Thor on it. Bounce light in here. Play to our strengths. I know what bounce light is, so we're gonna roll with that. We'll... Someone hanging out in real life said they were reading comics and they pulled out X-Men Red. Was it the Chimichanga Deadpool thing? that I had done like forever ago with Brent Schoonover on the cover. That's cool. Yeah. You're like, I know that guy. All right. Yeah, the Telekinetic Chimichangas. Yeah, I know that cover. Alright. We have to do hair, and I feel like we should just black out everything and then just do the hair. Let's figure this out. Man, I did like three versions of that Telekinetic Chimichanga cover. And like, I feel like they picked the worst one. I'm trying to remember like what the hair like even looks like. Maybe I should have just drawn the hair. We goofed it, chat, and I blame you. Because you know what? Gotta blame someone. Maybe not. Maybe you were right, chat. Because I kind of like what's going on over here. Maybe we should just black it out. Let's just black it out and then white it out. Like maniacs. You played board games with one of the guy who made this. Oh, cool. Yeah. Man, we should play more board games, by the way. Was it you who were telling me that my Clank thing was not working? Or like the pieces got like deleted or whatever. Yeah, that was you. I dug through some hard drives and I found the pieces, but I haven't had time to fix it. I will fix it. I haven't had time yet. We should play more board games though, for sure. Was it just one image that broke? I also think that I was making, man, I feel like I... hold on, I gotta think about this for a second. I feel like I made all the images like way too big because I'm used to working in print. And it was like, I was making these like high res scans of like the board, and it's like, people look at the board and it's like this big on screen. Just like this big on screen. Alright. White it out, black it out. Black it out, white it out. I don't know if this is the right move, but it feels like the right move. Yeah, but those weirdos play at full zoom so they can see everything at once rather than set cameras so they can sweep. Yeah, that game is about setting up your cameras and just like navigating between them. You should not be full zoom. But it makes it difficult because it's like, you know, Boyko was streaming it, and before, even when I wasn't playing, I would, like, watch what you guys were up to. And, Sorry, I'm thinking about this hair. And I would watch his streams, and it was, like, so difficult to follow what's going on. Like, when you watch a stream... Oh my god, this paper's bending. It's bending right off the board. To be fair, we put a lot of ink down. Alright, you know what this needs? Something that I don't have readily available. But yeah, it was tough to follow board game streams. Because you want to see what's going on. This needs more metal. This is maximum metal. Wait, the stream or the piece? Oh, wait, this is way too much white. We put way too much down. It's fine. Oh my god, I'm getting it like all over me. This is a disaster. Don't let me around nice things. I haven't done a lot of this because I do this in like... Shit, don't let me around. Oh my god, this is just a total disaster. I haven't done a lot of like toothbrush stuff because I usually do it in Photoshop, so. I have no idea what I'm doing, and we're just gonna roll. Am I pointing it the right way? I don't know. It's like a fine mist. I guess this is fine. There, now you also have my fingerprint. Whoever gets this can also maybe open my iPhone. If I had an iPhone. Look at this. I'm a disaster. We need to play more Harry Potter. Yeah. Using that Kyle Wester thumbprint brush. Right. I don't even know. can we just... I don't know if this is good. This is probably not good. We should probably quit while we're ahead. Yeah, we're gonna quit while we're ahead. We're gonna stop trying to experiment. Never experiment. Professional finger paints. What's up, Boyko? How does this stream look in glorious 240p? Boyks is in his hometown in the middle of nowhere. Alright, now that we're a mess, I think that's it for today. We did a Thor right here that I can't keep on stream, apparently. Everything is blurred and it cuts out every 10 seconds. The perfect streaming experience. We did a Thor that I'm really happy with. Came out pretty cool. Did some experimenting. We did a Rook. That is pretty cool. Did some Chris Omni bullshit around it with playing with light. And we did a cool Wolverine. So I'm feeling stoked about that. If you guys are interested in picking any of these up, I'm going to bring them to Heroes Con. I think I'm going to charge like $40 for each. See how that price works. I don't know. We'll see. Thanks, Boyks. Sounds like mine till last week or your apartment went. Oh, jeez. That's a big jump from 500k. You really like that Rook? Yeah, that Rook came out pretty good. Alright. We're gonna try to do more of these tomorrow. Hopefully I'm able to. I'm not exactly sure when I'm leaving for Girls Con. Could be late tomorrow, could be early Friday. If you get there on Friday and I'm not there, it may take me a little while to get up there. We're driving up, so hang tight. Thanks, Sean. And yeah, we'll do a couple more of these, probably tomorrow. See you guys then. I'm gonna try to shut down the stream with my left hand. And thanks for hanging out. I know this isn't normally what I do. Thanks for hanging out.